हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल गोइंग विद यूनिट 3 सेल्स फोर्स मैनेजमेंट। इन सेल्स फोर्स मैनेजमेंट वी मैनेज द सेल्स फ्रॉम द रिक्रूटमेंट टू ट्रेनिंग एंड देयर मोटिवेशन एंड द सुपरविजन। सो वी विल गो विद द टॉपिक वाइज एंड पॉइंट टू पॉइंट। सो द फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज रिक्रूटमेंट एंड सेलेक्शन ऑफ सेल्स फोर्स। The recruitment and selection of sales force depend on the organization, how much quantity of they required, how much hiring they want. Yeah, we can say that how much salesmen they want in their organization, so that they hired. The never confuse with the recruitment and selection as the same thing. The recruitment means the process to call the people for the joining, and the selection is process to choose a person which is are come to join in your organization. So the first point is recruitment. The recruitment depends on the recruitment selection always go with side by side. The first recruitment happened and then selection is happened. So that is the four step we can taken down. So where the recruitment selection procedure happened, the first is deciding the quantity of sales force. The deciding of quantity sales force, again I said what, how much quantity, I mean said how much sales person the organization want to hire. Okay, that is decided by the sales manager, and the territory and the market capture by the organization, and it also depends on the production capacity, means how much want to reach his consumer. Secondly, determined the quality the possess by the salesperson. It's about creating a job description, a job analysis, where they can explain the qualities they want required, means the quality and performance they want in that particular job, and what kind of duty and responsibility and need to do when they will join in this job. Okay, whenever we decide about the jobs and job description. And so third point, come to source of recruitment. The source of recruitment, which usually we found out in the advertisement, means there the organization can go with any platform where they can hire a people. So first they call for the campus interviews, where they can say they can go for the advertisement where they advertise in the newspaper, or they can go for the hiring agency, means a placement agency. The placement agency, they hire the placement agency to do their job, means they hire the placement agency to hire their sales force. Okay, there are various sources to recruit for the recruitment. Where the recruitment is advertised, means they are published through the manner, and the application come and they call for the applicant, means they call for the candidate. When the candidate will come, now the selection process will start. This still further now, that is the recruitment process. Okay, where they decide the number of person they want, they decide the job description, and decide the source how to recruit. Whenever the recruitments come, mean the candidate come to the organization for the interviews or for the written exam, that means that the selection process start. How you select the your sales force is depend on the organization. Okay, there are various sources to hire your candidates. Means either it could be interview or the questionnaire, either written exam. Okay, it is by the group discussion. Okay, it's going to be a physical test. It depends on the organization. Okay, that's how whenever the past you when the mem jury member okay when the jury or we can say the board of member or the people who hiring, they are satisfied, they made the review list of the performance. On the basis of that, they hire their right candidate which is suitable for the job. When the candidate hired, okay, and they join the organization, it required a training, means okay, which is the next topic of this video. the training of the sales force. The training of the sales force is depend on the need of training. I mean, sometimes we give the training to the old employee also, and we give the training to the new employee. New employees are generally trained because of they are new to the organization. They don't know about the work ethics and the work culture about the company, and the, also they don't know about the product, what are they selling. So that's why we give the training about the product and about the company, so they can do the better performance. And as well as we do the give the training to the old employee to make them update in the present scenario. We keep updating about the product and the company policies. So that's why the training is Salesforce is very important. So whenever we do the training of Salesforce, we also need a training of a good training program. Means a good training program which relate to the training of the Salesforce, where they we consist for some kind of basic point. On that basis of point, we made a training program for the Salesforce. What are these points for the Salesforce? The fourth point is there. The first one is the basic principle of salesmanship. Whenever we try to make a training program of Salesforce, we always take care of the basic principle. Basic principle of salesman is how to get the attention of the customer, how to get the do the action, and how to inform about the product. Okay, whenever we do the training program, we always consider the knowledge of firm. Means whenever do training program, we always give the training about the company's policy, ethics, and his vision and missions. Okay, next is product knowledge about the product. When we give the training to the new employee, we always remember the part of the program that we what are we selling. Okay, what product our company is selling, that what product is, we give the information, give the training to the employee, so he can know better the product. And the fourth point which is considered in the training program is knowledge of the customer. Means it is related to the company's targeting market. Means company is targeting on what kind of customer it is, and what this and that kind of customer what they are, so what their behavior it is. So that company gives the training about this kind of customers, how to behave with them, how to tackle with them. This on the fourth point we made a training program. When we made the training program, what we do, how do we do this kind of training. Okay, so that's called a method of training, how we giving them a training. So there are different methods. First one is individual method, second one is a group method, third one is on the job, and last one is off the job. The first one, individual, is related to the four types of individual method we can give the training to the trainee. First one is initial, means a breaking in training. Means we give the break in part. Means we switch his department time to time. Okay, if you go through the fort, whenever if it's very taking a very easy example, if you want to learn about the hotel industry, where they give a initial breaking, means first you will do the job in F&B service, second will housekeeping, third will in kitchen, so you will understand easily about the hotel industry. That's why the similarly in the sales force, they give the job of the approaching telephonic conversation, when they go for the marketing, then we go for the reporting. So that you will divide the department wise. Okay, the second one is special assessment, to know to better performance how it is learning. We always give the special assignment which is are compared to very easier. Okay, and watch his performance or her performance. And third one is field coaching. It is very common method to give the training to the training. Field coaching means they always work with the seniors, where they can learn how to do the sale or how to do a job. And fourth one is sales manual. Sales manual is not nothing else, it is a manual booklet where there are things are written as you can say ideally, where the what to do and what not to do are written. Means it is a training guide manual where you can read and work according that, and do action according to that. And the second method is group method. The group method is very common phenomena because in there in very large common scenario they give the people always use the group method. It's very common giving the lecture to the sales force. It's very common. Lecture means giving the information about everything, our current problem and what is the cause of the training. Audio-visual method means playing the video about and giving the visual effect to that. The third one is conference, doing the video conference or audio conference. Case method, case means we took a case study and discuss about that and what are the review and what are the suggestion are there. And last point is the role playing. Role playing means we creating any kind of situation where we deciding to what role trainee will play. On the job method is the there are two types on the job rotation and field training. Field training means we directly choose a new training and give the job assignment in the field training. Means if you take example, we send the new representative for the sales opportunity, or we can say for the meeting call. And second point, job rotation means we switch a job rotation, means when we try to give teaching, yeah, we can try to train them in each and every department. Of the job method, the last method to give the training, it is the journals or bulletins, which is the organization or association will published in weekly or quarterly basis, where they can learn about the and upgrade his skill and knowledge about the sales. That is all about the training, select recruitment and selection of the sales force, and second topic, the training of the sales force. Next, we'll continue further in video. Thank you.